Well, if you ever talk to someone from this part of the Cape and say, well, where are you from? They rarely, if ever, say, well, I'm from Bourne. Instead, they will mention a particular part of the area or a specific neighborhood. And when they do, they speak about it with great pride, as they should. And that's all what makes this part of the Cape and this town of Bourne very unique. You can't get to Cape Cod without going through Bourne. It is the gateway to the Cape. All of the bridges, in fact, are in Bourne. Born in the USA, this town is the only Bourne in the USA.
Now, the residents of Bourne are really village people. No, not those guys. The Bourne identity is the 10 villages that make up this town. For example, we're here in Buzzards Bay, right along the Cape Cod Canal, in the shadow of the train bridge.
You have Buzzards Bay, Sagamore, Bourne Village, Montbeast, Pocasset, Atomic. And so each village is unique because of its own character.
And if you want to show your Bourne supremacy, you can come to the terrific gift shop, Twigs on the Water in Katahmet, at the Kingman Yacht Center, right next to the world-famous Chart Room. It's where you can find a T-shirt representing just about every village in town.
My business partner and I just bought the store in the fall, and we had no idea the depth of the passion that people have for their villages around here. So we're happy to be able to provide all of the T-shirts and hats that they are looking for.
And one of these villages is of particular nostalgic value to me. This was my aunt's cottage down here in Pocasset, right off Wings Neck Road, and I spent more summers here than I can remember. And what a great place to summer. Man, we rode our bikes everywhere, up to Howie's, we played wiffle ball in the backyard, walked to the beach, and yeah, I even took part in the annual Pocasset Beach Field Day. That's me right there with the floppy hair and the blue shorts taking part in the three-legged race. Gray Gables is another village in Bourne, a place with historical significance. Gray Gables was the site of the first ever summer White House on the Cape. It's where President Grover Cleveland vacationed. His home was a Gray Gable, hence the name of the area. That home burned down in the 1970s. This train station was made just for him, although it moved from its original location just down the road, which is represented by this memorial stone. Well, the town of Bourne is on the water, and when you come to Bourne, well, you want to get on the water. And we're going to do just that. My good friend Steve Vasson is going to take us out on his boat to show us some of the villages of Bourne from the water.
Welcome aboard.
And with Steve's son Stephen at the helm, our ocean tour was underway. So you know, this is a wonderful town with all those villages. That's more than just these bridges. But what exactly is the Bourne legacy?
Affordable, close-knit, and it is a very special place.
It's talking to bass photographer Andy Devine over here. I think we got every song with a Bourne in the chorus in there, didn't we? Yeah, thumbs up on that one. Now, keep in mind, very interesting about Bourne, that the town runs the full length of the canal. So the town is divided by the Cape Cod Canal. You've got one part of the town that's on the mainland side, if you will, and the other part of the town is on the Cape side. So if you live in Buzzards Bay, for example, and you go to Bourne High School, well, you got to cross over the bridge, right, and go to school and then cross back over the bridge to get home. Or if you live on the Cape side of Bourne and you have business to do at Town Hall, which is in Buzzards Bay, well, you got to go over the Bourne Bridge to be able to take care of that. So people here in Bourne have to factor in bridge traffic more than any other community here on the Cape. So that's one thing that certainly makes this place unique. And the other thing is those bridges are about to be replaced down the road. We're going to talk more about that project and that proposal and what it could mean for residents of Bourne coming up in just a few